Whether it's a hurricane, earthquake, or other disaster, those who are affected by crisis usually need four vital things: food, shelter, water, and blood. In particular, O-type blood, because it can be safely given to any patient. Now, scientists say they have identified enzymes from the human gut that can turn type A and B blood into type O up to 30 times more efficiently than previously studied enzymes. Type A or B blood has specific sugars on the outside of its cells. These sugars are recognized by the immune system, and if they don't match the type of blood that's already in an individual, those cells are destroyed. Because these sugars are recognized by the immune system, they're called antigens. Type AB blood has both antigens, and type O blood has none. The researchers presented these findings at the recent American Chemical Society National Meeting in Boston. Stephen Withers from the University of British Columbia has been studying enzymes that remove A or B antigens from red blood cells. If those antigens can be removed, then type A or B can be converted to type O blood. To find the enzymes more quickly, Withers and a colleague at his institution used a technique called metagenomics, which allows scientists to sample the genes of millions of microorganisms without the need for individual cultures. Then, researchers used E. coli to select for DNA that codes for enzymes that can cleave sugar residues. Withers' team found candidate enzymes in the human gut microbiome. They chose this source because the gut wall is lined with glycosylated proteins called mucins that display a number of sugars, some of which are the A and B antigens. Certain bacteria in the gut are able to cut the sugars off the mucins, which gives them a food source. The researchers honed in on the enzymes the bacteria use to pluck the sugars off and found a new family of enzymes that are 30 times more effective at removing red blood cell sugars than previously reported candidates. Withers is working with colleagues at the Center for Blood Research at UBC to validate these enzymes and test them on a larger scale for potential clinical testing.